Hi everyone, did you hear about IoT? Yes, definitely, I know you have heard about IoT, but do you know something about NB-IoT? Maybe yes, or maybe not. My dear friends, in this lecture, I'm going to share something important about NB-IoT, which will help out you to understand IoT in a better way. So for next 5 to 10 minutes, be with me. Here I go. Did you know there was a time when having a car was just a beautiful dream and luxury too? And the same was with smartphone. Earlier, smartphone was luxury, but now it is our necessity. Today, we cannot deny the importance of cellular phone or smartphone. Because we are in the era of technology, so let's move on to catch up other important technology. Yes, I'm talking about Internet of Things. What is the Internet of Things? There was Mark Weiser, who was the father, who was the computer scientist. He said, come on, we always think about things. Why things can't think about us? It was a different and beautiful statement given by Mark Weiser, which later carried by Calvin Ishton, who is known as the father of IoT. And what is that Calvin Ishton and Mark Weiser concept? Both were focusing that the things which are around us, whether that is our toilet, kitchen, drawing room, household items, garage, they always think about us. They should ask, they should take order from us what we need. And if we are just giving order to them, they should obey it. They must not be important as we are. So what is in fact IoT? IoT is the network of physical objects or things, the things that are embedded with sensors, software, and other technologies for the purpose of connecting and exchanging data with other devices and systems over the internet. So in IoT, things are embedded with some important sensors, some software and other related technologies for connecting and exchanging data over the internet. IoT present scenario. Experts believe that IoT is penetrating our life in the same way as mobile phone. In a research, approximately 30 billion objects are connected to the internet presently, which is really a huge number. Do you know what is the population of world right now? Yes, it is only 7.7 billion. It is estimated that more than 70 billion devices will be connected to the internet by the year 2025. The number was just moving more than doubles. Of course, things are not going to stop here and they should not stop. It is just a wonderful start and soon it will be dazzling for all of us and will lure every human being on this earth planet. And IoT ensure that nobody is going to escape the magic of this beautiful technology. Then what does NB-IoT mean? IoT is important. But is IoT depends on other technology? Yes, NB-IoT is such a leverage technology for IoT. NB-IoT is abbreviated as Narrowband IoT. NB-IoT is a 3GPP wireless communication, which stands for Third Generation Partnership Project. This is a standard given by ITU, International Telecommunication Union, for the 3.75, 4G and 5G standards as well. It is especially suited for high volume of low complexity devices in challenging radio environment, such as underground radio signal penetration. It is especially suited for the signal where signals are hard to reach. There are a lot of places like basement, like rocky places, water bodies, forest areas. Here, signals are kept or remain minimum. It is one technology out of several competing technology available for IoT. For example, Sigfox, LoRa, WAN, LTE-M, etc. It is not like that NB-IoT is the only leverage technology for IoT. There are some other important technology which is becoming popular parallel to the NB-IoT. But NB-IoT is designed to expand the future of IoT connectivity in a more secure and reliable way because it provides certain advantage or features over other technology. What is the meaning of narrowband in NB-IoT? In radio communication, what is radio communication? A communication which takes place without wire, or the communication takes place with the help of radio frequency. So in radio communication, a narrowband channel is a channel in which the bandwidth of the message does not significantly exceed the channel's coherence bandwidth. What is coherence bandwidth? That is, narrowband implies that the channel under consideration is sufficiently narrow enough that its frequency response can be considered flipped. So whatever channels or frequency we are selecting, it is kept. It is remains so flat that the response is considered flat throughout that frequency band. But what is the need of narrowband channel? Where and why narrowband is used? So the application which requires long range, low power, reliable communication, narrowband is the best choice. So one thing should be pretty sure. The application which requires long range transmit, low power transmission and reliable communication, we can use narrowband channel over there. This is the figure versus narrowband and broadband signals. The graph is between the frequency and power transmission. In the figure, narrowband occupies less bandwidth as shown in the blue color peak. It occupies less bandwidth compared to the broadband system, which occupies more bandwidth. And one more thing which you can notice, that noise is more in broadband signal because broadband signal and noise have the more interactive area. So what are those features or properties of NB-IoT which is really different with other existing technology? First point is easy deployment into existing cellular network architecture. First important difference is NB-IoT is deployed into existing cellular network, which is meant for third generation, fourth generation, and fifth generation. Low power consumption. It consumes very low power, so less that they can run up to 10 years. Extended indoor and outdoor range. NB-IoT provides more indoor and outdoor ranges, approximately 164 dB. Low bandwidth requirement. Narrow channel only limited up to 180 kilohertz. You know, frequency spectrum is always an issue for the mobile or wireless communication. Channel, narrowband channel provides low bandwidth, low frequency, which can be available easily. Low latency. NB-IoT provides only less than 10 seconds latency as compared to other technologies. And one more important feature of NB-IoT is support more than 1 lakh connections per cell. You know, cellular networks, geographical area are divided into small cells. And one cell can accommodate 1 lakh IoT devices. This is the power of NB-IoT. Low hardware component costs. Apart from all these unique features, one important factor which make it different to others technology is lower hardware cost. And hardware cost always make the difference choosing the technology for the mass. Now, I told you that NB-IoT is the leverage technology for IoT. What I mean, I'm just talking about in terms of frequency band used in NB-IoT. NB-IoT uses mobile carrier network for its communication rather than using local Wi-Fi or local network frequencies. Other IoT technology devices depends on Wi-Fi or cable network, but it is not with the case of NB-IoT. NB-IoT uses mobile carrier. That is the carriers which are used for the mobile transmission in 3.7 5G, 4G, and 5G. There are three different modes in which NB-IoT can be operated. So let's try to get what are those three important bands in which NB-IoT can be operated. First one is in-band operation in which one PRB of LT carrier is used for NB-IoT. The first band, in-band of LTE, long-term evolution, which belongs to the 3.75 and 4G generation. One PRB, that is one physical radio band, is dedicated to NB-IoT only out of many band. And the frequency is 180 kilohertz of that carrier. Guard band operation uses a resource block within LTE carrier. As you know, that when we transmit one signal and the other signal, then we separate both signals with the help of guard band. And that guard band is sometimes becomes waste for us. And thanks to this NB-IoT, NB-IoT using that guard band for its transmission. Isn't it quite interesting? And the third one is standalone operation uses GSM 200 kilohertz. GSM is known as the global system for mobile communication. It is a second generation mobile services. In second generation, the bands available are 800, 900 megahertz, 850 megahertz, and 450 megahertz. So that bands are broken into small pieces of frequency having the value 200 kilohertz. I mean, only 200 kilohertz band is given to the single user. And in GSM, we have total 125 frequency carriers. One is kept always in reserve. So out of 24 bands, one band is allocated to NB-IoT for its proper functioning or operation. So these are three modes of operation in terms of frequency band, which are using LTE and GSM spectrum in the most efficient way, because we are running out all frequency spectrum. They are so costly. They are less in number. You know, every year government has bids and they have a lot of corruption also on related to these frequency spectrum. But I'm not going to that thing. So guys, it was all about NB-IoT. I hope you got it. How did you like the lecture? If you liked it, please encourage me by just putting your valuable comments. If you are not getting it, let me know. If nothing is clear to you, let's have a Q&A session. I would like to clear your doubts as far as concerned, but your feedback is important to me. So I hope today onwards, if you are going to make any IoT network, then you can opt one technology for its operation, that is NB-IoT. I mean, how you are going to set up the network. You can set up the network with the help of this beautiful and very cute technology, NB-IoT. Anzar Ahmed signing out. Until we meet again.